Okay, Chris, that was a good job on the missed approach there. As you can see, I've just reconfigured the weather for thunderstorms. This approach is going to be a fully protected CAT III ILS approach into runway 36 right at Orlando. You've got that, yeah?
36 right into Orlando ILS approach.
Okay, I'm going to hand over control to you now. We're just leveling at 1-1000, 11000, direct to Noggy. Can you set GPS direct to the Bairn intersection for me, please? You have
GPS direct to Bairn.
Yep, you have control.
Okay, proceeding GPS direct to Bairn. Show us 1-2 miles.
Right, Chris, maintain the current speed and take us down to 8,000. Check the altimeter, 29 or 21.
Okay, down to 8,000. Maintain current speed. Altimeter indicator is 29 or 21.
Okay, Chris, just confirm that we've got the Goofy 5 arrival set up on Nav 1. The frequency is 112.2 for the Orlando VOR and the radial 162.
We are configured for the Goofy 5 and the radios are set to the proper frequency and course.
Okay, cool. When we get to Bairn, 8 miles away, what I want you to do is make a right-hand turn, roll out heading 040 degrees and pick up the 162 radial northbound, inbound on the Goofy 5, and then we're going to pick up the CAT III ILS for 36 right.
Okay, so when we get to Bairn, we'll turn right to 040 to pick up the radial and then we'll make the ILS approach for 36 right.
That's all correct. All right. Whenever you're ready, set your course, set your heading now 116 on the heading bug and disconnect the GPS and we're going to go fully auto.
Okay, going fully auto, disconnecting. Just confirm we're going roll out to 040 on the heading after reaching Bairn.
After reaching Bairn, initiate a right turn and then roll out heading 040.
Okay, reach Bairn 040.
Alright, I'm just adjusting the heading bug now to 116 and heading control, GPS is disconnected.
Okay, GPS is disconnected, turning to 040.
Right hand turn, Chris. It's a right hand turn initially and then roll out heading 040.
Okay, right turn and then roll out 040.
Right, I'm just going to identify the Orlando VOR on Nav 1. Speed back to 250 and there's the ident for the Orlando VOR.
Okay, slowing to 250.
Okay, the Goofy 5 specifies 8,000 up to the Bairn intersection, and then after Bairn's northbound, the minimum safe radar vectoring altitudes are 2,600 to Odell and then 2,600 to the field. So you can descend and maintain 4,000 and again check the altimeter 29021.
Okay, down to 4,000 and the altimeter is 29021.
As we pass through about 6,000, we should start picking up some of the bad weather. So what you need to do is bring the speed back and just sit back and just let the autopilot deal with it.
Slowing to 220 and we'll expect the weather. And we are continuing our turn to 040.
Hey, firm. Keep a clean configuration for the moment until we're down to 4,000 feet. So just keep the flaps up. Let's stay clean until we're down at 4,000.
Okay, acknowledge we'll stay clean until reaching 4,000.
Getting bumpy, huh?
We are bouncing around a little bit.
Okay, Chris, do you want to set the, on the NAV 1 secondary, do you want to set the ILS frequency and the course heading for 36 right, please?
Okay, on NAV 2, we'll set the frequency and course for the 36 right to ILS approach. And just confirm we are at 4,000, slowing to 220 knots.
Roger. Once you roll out on the heading of 040, start bringing back flaps as required for the speed, and then start tracking the radial northbound once that CDI needle starts to move.
Okay, we'll flaps as needed, and we'll adjust based on the needle. Okay, the ILS frequency is in NAV 2, and we've got our course set at 0162 right now. We'll change it to 004 for the ILS setting.
Watch out. Okay, needle's moving.